you can open up the developer tools by going to this hamburger menu here and going down to more tools and then developer tools. Personally, I'm a fan of actually hitting Command Alt J on a Mac, although it's slightly different on other platforms, but it brings that up straight away without having to do anything else. Now we're in DevTools, we need to go to the Timeline tool, which is right up here. Timeline is here to allow you to track frames per second for your project. You can record a timeline and it will tell you what frames per second you were getting and for each frame, what work was involved. That work will tie back into the pipeline you learned in the last lesson. Now I'm going to hit record, which is up here in the top corner, and then I'm going to scroll around the site. Now I can stop the recording and I get a load of records back. At first glance, I think the user interface can be a little bit overwhelming, so let's just look at it bit by bit. The bars at the top indicate the frames per second. There's this 60 frames a second line and a 30 frames a second line. If we're trying to hit 60 frames a second, all these bars should be below that line. Now, we're pretty close to the line here, but overall, we're doing pretty well. Underneath, there's a load of information about how we spent our time in each of the frames. Right now, it's quite zoomed out, so we need to actually dive in a little bit deeper. To do that, we simply click drag in the frames area at the top, and now you see it's zoomed in a little bit more. You can also use the W, A, S, and D keys on your keyboard if you prefer. Here in the details, you can see the parts of the pipeline we discussed earlier. There's JavaScript, there's style calculations, layout, layer management, paint, and composite. If you've never taken a timeline recording before, I'm going to give you a chance to pause this video in a moment so you can go and take your first recording. Go to any website, it doesn't matter which, and hit record in the timeline. Then explore the timeline and see what you can find out. Ready? Pause! Okay, cool. You're able to take timeline recordings and you can quickly see where you're hitting Jank. But now you need to start digging into the details of those frames and figure out why frames are running long.